I, Dexter Ota, on behalf of my class, would like to extend a warm welcome to respected MD sir, teachers, and my dear friends. It is a pleasure to have you all here for the annual presentation of class 10S on the topic Indian versus Chinese economy. We have got a really exciting and informative show for you, and we hope that you enjoy every moment of it. Every day begins with the blessings of God. So now let's start the show with Ganesh Vandana.
Farming system used trident and modern techniques to cultivate our farms.
there will be no private properties. Everything will be under the state control. You can use this for your work.
Okay, sir. As you say.
Scene 3. Jawaharlal Nehru is sitting with P.C. Mahalanobis, who is a great statistician. They are discussing the second five-year plan of India for the year 1956 to 1961 with the other leaders.
If we want a rapid and steady development, we will have to focus on our industries. For the power economy, we need iron and steel industries, power projects, etc. We will utilize it.
Yes, our industries need to be developed. The iron and steel industries will be the backbone of our economy.
Yes, I agree with you. We will allocate 50 billion rupees in various fields to achieve our targets.
China's second five-year plan is also known as Great Leap Forward.
It's time to take a great leap forward. I want China to grow rapidly. For this, we need factories. You all have to establish a backend industry in your houses and produce something for the society.
Okay, sir.
Mao is standing and suddenly notices a bird feeding on some grains. He gets disturbed and calls his men.
One bird is taking one grain. Thousands of birds will take thousands of grain. I order you all to kill all the birds and rats. No one is allowed to take the grains of China like this.
Okay, sir. We will kill all these birds and rats. No one dares to disobey your instruction.
This brutal step resulted in pest attack. As the birds were killed, their harvest were destroyed by the pest attack, which caused millions to starve and die. Scene 5, Economic Reforms of China. Deng Xiaoping is also known as the father of China's economic transformation. Deng is talking to his people.
Open China's doors for the world. Give them all the facilities. Attract them to set up their businesses here. Make business policies so liberal that everyone, all the powers, will be compelled to work with us. Make business laws flexible. I want China to become the largest producer of each and every single thing. I want China to be the largest producer of each and every single thing. Make everything so affordable that people from any economic background would find it easy to purchase every single thing.
Okay, sir, we will do the same and China will become the largest producer.
China's open door policy in 1978 brought a dramatic effect in the economy.
Scene 6, Economic Reforms of India. India opened its doors to all in 1991. Dr. Manmohan Singh, the then Finance Minister, and Mr. P.V. Narasimha Rao, the then Prime Minister, were instrumental in bringing out the policy named Liberalization, Privatization and Globalization, which opened the doors of the Indian market to all. When India was going through an economic crisis, our Prime Minister grew worried and talked to Dr. Manmohan Singh.
What happened, sir? You look really worried.
India is going through a big economic crisis. We don't have much dollars left with us. How will we purchase petrol? If this continues, everything will come to a halt. We can't let this happen. You need to think of something, Dr. Manmohan Singh ji.
Yes, sir. You are right. India is going through a tough time. And we would definitely think of something.
It was then that Dr. Manmohan Singh came up with the liberal economic reforms.
India is going to create history today. I know that history will be kinder to me than the media. These reforms would lead India on the golden road to become the economic superpower.
Scene 7, Present Time India. After economic liberalization, many MNCs across the globe came to India with their investment. It was a huge step which significantly reduced unemployment.
I am the CEO of Volkswagen. Wow, India is a great market for my cars. I will make a huge profit. I am so happy to invest in India.
I am the CEO of Samsung. After the relaxation in license policy, it has become very easy for us to invest in India. I have a huge market for my products like washing machines, televisions and many more.
India has come a long journey and has an equally long journey ahead. Though we are able to live a comfortable life, we must continue to thrive and make India an ideal nation. Thank you.
India got freedom in 1947 and formation of People's Republic in China took place in 1949. At that time, GDP of both the countries was almost equal undoubtedly. In per capita income, India was ahead of China. Today, through this group discussion, we will put forth some interesting and worthy facts about the economy of both the nations. Divish, can you please tell us something about the economic journey of India?
According to Angus Madison, a British historian, when British came to India in 1700, India's share in world economy was about 23%. But when they left India in 1947, it dropped to 3%. British ruined India's economy and left us in a deprived and a pitiable condition. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, our first Prime Minister, shouldered the responsibility to handle the India's bubbling economy. Our leaders' farsightedness and crucial planning in that era made India run on a track of economic growth.
Dhruv, can you please tell us what steps were taken by Indian government to accelerate the economic growth?
An official body, the Indian Planning Commission, was established in 1950 and the first five-year plan was made in 1951, in which a special focus was laid on the development of agriculture and irrigation. It was drafted by great economist K.N. Rao. After that, India built dams, canals, power projects for the development of agriculture. In the second five-year plan, which was made in 1956, the special focus was laid on the development of industrial sector. It was drafted by great statistician P.C. Mahalanobis. According to him, for a rapid and stable growth, we needed to establish power projects and industries.
Daksh, can you please put some light on the initial economic policies of China?
In 1949, China established People's Republic of China under the leadership of Mao Zedong. He led to a campaign called the Great Leap Forward. It was also a five-year plan to reconstruct the country from an agrarian economy to a communist society. According to this plan, people were encouraged to establish a banking industry in almost every house.
Chirag, what steps and policies did China and India adopt to make a huge growth?
In China, their leader Deng Xiaoping opened its economy to the rest of the world in 1978. His policies shifted the nation from a centrally planned economy to the market-based ones. These economic reforms helped China to increase its GDP on a huge scale, whereas in India, the economic reforms were launched in 1991. Finance Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, under the leadership of P.V. Narasimha Rao, opened India's economy to foreign investment and brought the policy of liberalization. This step changed India's fate and brought us in the list of strong economies.
Dhruv, can you please discuss the concept of special economic zone?
SEZ means special economic zone. This concept was initiated by China in 1979. China developed 6 SEZ where special benefits were required to attract MNCs. These benefits were labor at low wages, land at very low cost, port facilities, etc. India has also declared to create SEZ in 2000. Some SEZ of China are Shenzhen, Shanghai, Hong Kong, etc. Some SEZ of India are Gujarat, Haryana, UP, etc.
Can anyone please tell us more about it?
There are some differences between India's and China's special economic zone. In China, there are 6 special economic zones, whereas in India, there are 270 operational special economic zones. In India, tax relaxation is also available inside, whereas in China, in India, tax realization is also available outside of SEZ. Land acquisition is easy in China as no protest allowed. But in India, it is hard task due to democratic practice.
Mr. Ranj, can you please tell us about the products which are exported from India and China?
China has become the world leader in the production of computer hardware, electronic goods and e-vehicles. It is also the largest supplier of chipset in the world. India is also growing fast. Its IT sector has shown a tremendous growth in the past few years. India's steel production has increased and marked the historic level of 120 million tons per year, and India claims to be the second largest producer of steel in the world.
I wonder how China turned to be a global factory. Dipinder, can you please tell us about it?
China made special development forms, which means one state of China will make one kind of product. That's why one state is famous for clothes and other for toys. Even China's Yiwu city has become wholesale for the whole world. You can get idols of Indian god and goddesses there. Also, the material which is used in Indian festivals such as in Holi, Diwali and many more are being manufactured and imported from China.
Ishnu, can you please put some light on the GDP of both the countries?
China has gained economic strength over the years. In 1980, China's GDP was 10.3%. During 2021-22, there was a drastic fall in China's growth rate from 10.3 to 3%. But in terms of dollars, it holds a position of world's second largest economy after USA with $18.32 trillion. On the other hand, India's GDP in 1980 was 5.7%, which has increased in 2022 and showed a growth of 7.7%. Now, India has surpassed UK and holds the first position in the terms of economy.
Diana, please compare and contrast India and China's sector's contribution towards GDP.
In China, the contribution of agriculture to GDP was 7% in the year of 2018-19, whereas it was 16% in case of India. If we talk about industrial sector, China contribution was 41%, whereas in India, its share was 30%. Service sector has contributed highest to both the countries. For China, it was 52%, whereas in India, it was 54%.
Gitanji, can you please put some light on strengths and weaknesses of Indian economy?
Talking about the strengths of Indian economy, India has a population of over 1.4 billion now, which attracts foreign investment and creates business opportunities. The service sector contributes around 55% of India's GDP. India is also rich in natural resources like coal, iron ore, and many other minerals, which are used in industries like steel, power, etc. Talking about the weaknesses of Indian economy, India's inadequate infrastructure requires significant investment, particularly in areas like roadways, railways, and power to meet the demands of the growing economy. India has also noticed high levels of income inequality. Large portion of the population lives below poverty line, limiting the potential of our consumer market. India's complex regulatory environment and bureaucracy makes it difficult for the businesses to operate.
Dishita, can you please tell us about the strengths and weaknesses of Chinese economy?
Talking about the strengths of Chinese economy, large and growing manufacturing sector has been a key driver of Chinese economic growth. The industries such as textiles, electronics are dominating the entire world. Their strong infrastructures like vast networks of railways, highways and ports that connect countries different regions and facilitate trade. Talking about the weaknesses of Chinese economy, large and growing population is a big challenge for China, as it is expected that due to this, China is going to face decline in workforce and increase in healthcare costs. For economic growth, China has neglected environment on a large scale, due to which China is suffering from pollution. China is heavily dependent on exports, which makes it vulnerable on change in global demand and trade policies.
Guni, can you please tell us what changes took place after the launch of Make in India?
Make in India is an initiative by the Government of India, which is launched in 2014 to create and encourage companies to manufacture and assemble products made in India and incentivize dedicated investments into manufacturing. Various sectors have been opened up for foreign direct investment like railways, space, defense manufacturing, single brand retail, etc.
Devyanshi, please tell us about the exports from India and China in arms and defense technologies.
Indian export of arms and defense technologies has reached 13,400 in the ongoing 2022 to 2023 financial year, whereas China's arms export have dropped over the last 2 5-year periods, statistic released by the Stockholm International Peace Research Institute.
India and China both are rising powerful countries in Asia. Their bilateral trade has reached to a record of 77.82 billion. India's merchandise export has reached to a record of 422 billion in 2021-2022. Before comparing both the countries, we should also consider their political system. India has a big democracy with ethnic variety. It supports multi-party system, whereas China has no democracy. It supports single-party system. Human rights are often neglected there. Thank you.
Is the song. Your thoughts are the music. Now it's time for a melodious Hindi song.
would like to call two of my batchmates, Guneet and Dutt Sahota, for a wonderful English poem.
Like a crouching tiger and a rising dragon, development and progress, their common slogan.
Are the two countries of India and China, giving rest to the world, heartache and angina.
Their strength lies in the history, now rewriting every man's story.
Remnants of surviving Asian civilization, astonishing is the rise of these two nations.
Reminding us of the changing trends, putting the dominance of West to an end.
Slowly shifting to the center of power, let these two giants last forever.
On them may Buddha bless and smile.
Let them walk together many a mile.
Now I would like to welcome Diksha Chaudhary for the Hindi poem.
Aao chalo, hum Bharat ka sudhar kare. Aao chalo, hum Bharat ka sudhar kare. Shiksha aur udyog ko aage badhate chale. नई तकनीकों का हम मिलकर आविष्कार करें, अपनी स्वर्णिम मातृभूमि का सत्कार करें, ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों को शहर जैसा बनाएं, ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों को शहर जैसा बनाएं, शिक्षा के क्षेत्रों में गांव को आगे बढ़ाएं, दूसरे देशों की चीजों का बहिष्कार करें, अपने देश में निर्मित चीजों को स्वीकार करें, जिन देशवासियों में हुनर का नशा है, जिन देशवासियों में हुनर का नशा है, उन्होंने ही आज तक देश को बुना है। यही नव पीढ़ी है जो भारत का विकास करेगी, यही नव पीढ़ी है जो भारत का विकास करेगी, एक ना एक दिन भारत को उन्नति प्रदान करेगी। विदेशी छोड़ स्वदेशी अपनाएंगे, अलग यही देश में जगाएंगे, नए व्यापारों को आगे हम बढ़ाएंगे, भारतवासियों को नए नए रोजगार दिलाएंगे, हम ही है जो देश को आगे बढ़ाएंगे, हम ही है जो देश को आगे बढ़ाएंगे, अपने व्यापार को दूसरे देशों में फैलाएंगे। आओ चलो हम भारत का सुधार करें, आओ चलो हम भारत का सुधार करें, शिक्षा और उद्योग को आगे बढ़ाते चलें। धन्यवाद।
class.
Thank you. We'll be right back.